Oh shit! Oh,
oh my god! Oh my god! Put the lid on it! Put it on the counter!
Hey yo, what's good? It's your boy Wolfie. Welcome back to DIY Wolfie. The other day I saw a video by Simple Cooking Channel on how to make bubblegum. And honestly, I never really thought about how the fuck to make bubblegum until I saw that video. So I will leave his link in the description below. Like, let me ask you a question. Does anybody at home know how to make bubblegum? You don't.
No.
Nobody knows how to make bubblegum. And if you do know how to make bubblegum, shut up. I don't care. I'm gonna teach you anyways. Like, literally, what the fuck is the first step on how to make bubblegum? Nobody knows. But don't worry, DIY Wolfie is gonna teach you. But before I make the bubblegum, you guys know I love my lights. And I happen to have a shit mode of warheads. And I was gonna do a challenge with these warheads, but then I read a lot of comments on my last shot glass making video, and a lot of you guys want me to make warhead shot glasses. So I got my shot glass mold. So if you guys want me to make warhead shot glasses, go down and smash that thumbs up button. If we can hit 120,000 thumbs up, your boy will make warhead shot glasses.
I'm not cleaning that up.
Mom!
I'm not cleaning that up.
I didn't think about this before I ripped it open. Okay, I'll be back in a sec. So if you guys want to see me make warhead shot glasses, you guys already know I'm the shot glass king. Go down and smash that like button right now. If we can hit 120K, I'll do warhead shot glasses. And I need good luck with this gum because you guys already know DIY Wolfie is probably the biggest failure on the planet. Anyways, let's do this. So to start, you need a bowl, some corn syrup, some icing sugar, some glycerin or glycerol, I don't know what the fuck this shit is. I bought this at Shoppers Drug Mart. This does not look edible. I found this beside the rubbing alcohol, so I don't think you're supposed to put this in your body, but you know, we don't give a fuck on this channel. We're gonna cook it anyways. If I die, just remember to fucking verify Wolfie Raps. How about that, Twitter? Some citric acid. You know, this stuff came right from the lemons. I have no clue what the fuck this shit is. Some food coloring, some flavoring. I got strawberry flavor, watermelon, grape, and I got spearmint. And last but not least, obviously you need the gum chewing kit. This thing fucking sucks all the fun out of it. I came into this expecting to make gum from scratch. Okay, I don't want gum base to make my gum. What is a gum base made out of? Tell me that. Then maybe I can make gum from scratch. How about that? Fucking gum, how it's made, fucking people. So in this gum chewing kit, basically all we're gonna take from it is the gum base. This is what you need in order to make gum. Yeah, this kit comes with everything else, but like honestly, we're DIY, so, oh. Yeah, this gum kit comes with basically everything else, but honestly, we're DIY, hey, fuck out of here.
Get it in the garbage.
Everything went in the garbage, and then this came out because it was supposed to go in the recycle. Meant to do that. So let me just make sure before I make this, let me just read the instructions. Fuck the instructions. How about I can actually need the instructions. Make sure you have an adult. Okay, fuck. Make sure you have an adult. What the fuck? I'm trying to make gum, not fucking do shit that requires an adult, like drinking shit. Anyways, the first step, you want to get a third of a cup of the gum mix and just put it in there. Next step. Let me check the next step on Google. Definitely forget the last step. All right, the next step is you want to put in 3 tablespoons of this glycerin USP stuff. I don't know what the difference between a tablespoon and a teaspoon is. This could be a tablespoon, teaspoon, we'll never know. But honestly, to play the measures safe, we're just gonna use a ladle. How about that? So yeah, when you're dealing with corn syrup, you know, so let's just put that in. There we go. Okay, you know what? This shit's taking way too long. We don't have patience for this. We're just gonna, I can't. That's definitely 3 tablespoons. I don't give a shit anymore. So next, you just wanna add 1 teaspoon of this glycerin stuff. If you add any more than 1 teaspoon, my dad told me I would have diarrhea for the next fucking month straight, so I'm just not gonna show with this. Just for the sake of my asshole, as every chef would say, the most accurate way you can ever measure something is fuck a spoon, use a fork. So we're just gonna measure it, make sure it actually just goes on the fork properly. So 1 tablespoon, there we go, perfect. 1 tablespoon, or 1 fork, just like every chef would say.
No one has
ever. One chef in the world has definitely said something like that.
Mm-mm.
Yes, they have. So next we're gonna need 1/2 teaspoon of citric acid. I overestimated the fuck out of this because look how much shit I bought. So we're just gonna measure with our eyes. You never wanna measure with anything except with your eyes. Every chef said that.
No.
Every chef said that. Yeah, maybe just a little more. So 1/2 teaspoon of that. Probably was more than 1/2 teaspoon. The next part is the best step, adding the flavoring. So I'm kind of cheesed about the flavoring because as soon as I went in the store, the girl told me that they ran out of ass flavoring and like I was really pumped about that because you know your boy loves to eat his ass and I'm kind of cheesed they only gave me fucking strawberry and grape. Like who actually eats strawberry and grape flavored gum? Back where I'm from, where all the fucking famous chefs are from, where I'm getting all these quotes, they only eat ass flavored gum. So it is what it is. I guess today, for the sake of you guys, we'll make gum that nobody eats strawberry. What the fuck? Strawberry gum? Like I've never heard of that shit. So with the flavoring, you're only supposed to add 1/2 teaspoon, but your boy loves this flavoring. I just fucking used it all. I don't give a shit. Like, what's the fun in having like decent gum? I want the most strong gum ever. And this shit smells lit as fuck. Oh my god, strawberry is amazing. Smell this.
Mmm.
Ah! So once you are done all that, you want to place it in the microwave for 60 seconds. And then after 60 seconds, you're going to check on it, see if it's good. And if it's still not good, you're going to put it back in for 30 seconds at a time. So let's get it. 60 seconds, 60. Okay, that's fucking 6 minutes. All right, 30, 3 minutes. What the fuck is this express cook bullshit? Power? Okay, no. All right, 2 minutes.
A few moments later.
Okay, so a minute just passed. Let's see what we got here. Oh, that's looking nice. So what you want to do is you just want to twirl it around nicely. Guys, this smells so good. I know it doesn't look like gum yet. Make sure to mix all the flavoring in it. So honestly, guys, I don't know what the fuck this is supposed to look like. So I'm going to go check Google, make sure everything's good. So we're going to put it back in the microwave for around like 30 seconds. I think that should be fine. Any longer than 30 seconds, then the gum's going to completely fuck up. So don't put it in for longer.
You know there's a 30 second button right here.
Yeah, I like the 2 minute button. So this is my favorite step, guys, the food coloring, because honestly this looks like shit right now. So food coloring can be really hard to open, but there's a really quick trick to open it. So what you're gonna want to do is put your feet shoulder width apart, put your arms out like this. Jacob Sartorius himself taught me this trick, you feel me? You're gonna bring your hand down and judo chop it while screaming out hit or miss by Jacob Sartorius. Of course, go buy it on iTunes, pre-order it right now. And as soon as you hit it, the wrapper should magically come off. All right, here we go. 3, 2, 1, sweatshirt! Ah! You see that? No wrapper. Wrapper's right there. It works every time. 95% of the time, it works 50% of the 50 times. So anyways, like I was saying, my favorite part. Depending on what color you want your gum to be, the more or less food coloring you add. So your boy Wolfie's just gonna do a quick... You see, the regular person would add just a bit, but I wanna eat my gum like it looks like a fucking dead body. This is so fucking nasty. Look at this shit.
You definitely put way too much.
So all the easy steps are done now. We are going into the hardest step. This is the make it or break it moment. If I fuck this up, there is no gum. So guys, please go down and hit that like button right now. I really don't wanna fuck this up. I need all the good luck I can get. But you know your boy Wolfie's a gambling man, and this wouldn't be fun if I didn't gamble anything. So if I fuck this up and this doesn't work, Sylvia, I will give you $100.
Just give it to me right now. It's not gonna work.
Put your hand back.
Please, thanks.
Just hold your hand back.
Okay.
All right, you're not getting shit. This is where you wanna grab your icing sugar. And what you wanna do with your icing sugar, I'm not gonna measure shit, I don't care. I know I'm getting this right the first time. Put it on your cutting board. A lot of icing sugar. That's definitely probably too much, that's definitely too much icing sugar. Next, you're gonna flatten it out, make a little bit of a hole in the middle of the icing sugar. Okay, guys? Just like that. Let the gum ooze into the middle of the icing sugar. Scoop out the rest right there. Okay, so it definitely went out the outside. You know, cover it around. That's what's meant to happen. So right now you're supposed to wait like a minute because apparently this shit is supposed to be extremely hot, but I don't have patience. Just like I don't preheat my oven on DIY Wolfie, I don't wait. So we're just gonna start right away. Just gonna give it a little feel. That's hot as fuck. We need more icing sugar. Okay, so you're gonna put more icing sugar on top, and we're gonna do a technique called kneading. So basically what you're gonna do is fold the gum over and over and then roll it out, and then just continue that until it looks like actual edible gum. So we're just gonna grab the... Ah, that's fucking hot! Oh shit, okay, we're gonna wait 2 minutes. So I'm definitely making a mess, and I know a lot of chefs that actually make shit are watching me at home like, this 2-year-old is an idiot. And you know what? That's when I say, maybe this 17-year-old's an idiot. How about that? So yeah, fold it over, roll it down this way, put some more icing sugar, and just keep repeating this until it actually looks like gum. Okay guys, so it's been about 5 minutes, and this shit is actually looking very delicious right now. Look at this. So we got a long, like, cow tongue. It's stretchy, just like actual gum. You're supposed to have a rolling pin. I don't have a rolling pin, but I do have this giant log. This could have been outside. I don't know why the fuck it's in my kitchen, but we're gonna use it to roll out the gum. Yeah, this log might have not been the best option. Anyways, you want to flatten it out, and yeah, we're just gonna cut it up and then taste test. Okay guys, so I might have put a little too much icing sugar because this thing is literally just such a hard, like, rock blob. I'm gonna eat it in a second, but in order to eat it, I need to cut it up into gum. So knife Wolfie's coming out. So when you're cutting gum, you just want be careful. Just give it a nice, okay, that's a flop. You know what, guys? We're just gonna eat a nice tongue of gum. So the regular person would have like a little piece, but yeah, this is amazing. I definitely put too much here.
Too much what?
Too much flavoring. Ah! It tastes so good, but the texture is so bad.
Maybe measure with actual measuring.
Yeah, I think I need to measure, guys. It tastes so good, but it tastes like I'm eating grains of sand in my gum. We're gonna retry that. I'm gonna try with two other flavors and I'm gonna come back to you guys when we're on the last step.
Eventually.
Okay guys, so we just finished making the other two flavors of gum. The moment of truth. Hopefully this works. We actually use the oven for this one because I think the microwave just fucked it up the first time. People always use the microwave as the easy way out instead of the oven because it takes less time. But I got all day. So my stuff is in the oven right now and let's take it out. 3, 2, 1, go. Oh shit! Oh my god! What the hell is going on?
Put the lid on it!
What the fuck?
Put the lid on it! Put it on the counter!
Oh shit! Okay! Okay! Now that that's under control. I'm just choking, guys. We put it in the fucking microwave. Obviously, I'm not gonna light the house on fire, even though I almost just fucking by accident lit the house on fire. So we're gonna take it out of the microwave. Oh, I thought that was burnt.
Oh my god, me too.
Oh my god! Okay, this one's great. This one's great. We're good. So this is currently what the baking zone looks like with DIY Wolfie. I got the watermelon right here. Sylvia's working on the grape. We're gonna knead this stuff for like 5 minutes and then everything should be good. Hopefully this stuff works. I'm not gonna let it sit as long and I'm not gonna use as much icing sugar this time because I wanna actually be able to blow a bubble. That's my goal by the end of this. Okay guys, so just look at how gooey this one is. Look at how nice that looks. Basically, it's just a whole bunch of goo. All right, so I don't know what happened to the grape ones. These ones look like hard rocks, and I really don't want to chew this. I mean, I'll taste it for the sake of the video, but these honestly look like shit. But the watermelon one is looking lit. Watch how satisfying this cut is, guys. Just a nice little cut right there. Okay, that was a flop. This one, just a nice little cut right there. Look at these gumballs. Nice big rectangle. Here we go. Stick of gum, some gumballs there. Sylvia, you want a stick of gum? I'll cut you one anyways. So here we go. Just a classic stick of gum. Let's see. Watermelon taste test. This might be successful. This is delicious, but the question is, does it bubble? So guys, I've been chewing it for about 30 seconds, and I'm not no noob gum chewer, okay? I chew gum every day. In all of my videos, you guys can see my tongue's always blue because I'm always chewing gum. So if I can't blow a bubble with this, then it's a flop. I'm gonna be honest, the flavor was lost in about 10 seconds. The flavor was amazing in that 10 seconds, but it was gone. It still kind of has its color, but the color, as you can see, is already lost, so I've just inhaled a bunch of food coloring into my system. It's good because I haven't been able to swallow it. It's still gum, but here we go. Why it's so hard? Come on, please. Please just blow the bubble. It's so hard. I need a fucking tongue workout. Oh my god. It's not fucking happening. We'll try with the grape. This grape looks so unappetizing. I should have just followed the instructions, guys.
I never wanna look at the grape again.
We'll keep my stick. So that is it. As you can see, gum is not as easy to make as it may seem. You know, I thought this was just gonna be easy. For fuck's sake, I bought a gum chewing kit. Like, how can you go wrong with a gum chewing kit? What the hell? So I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to give it a big thumbs up. Remember, if you hit 120K likes, your boy is gonna do warhead shot glasses because you guys seem to just keep wanting me to do shot glasses, like warhead shot glasses, Skittles shot glasses, which I'll do. Just let me know in the comments or hit the like button. Duct tape shot glasses, you guys have been messaging me. I don't know why you guys still want shot glasses, but I'll do them because Wolfie's all about the people. I don't care about myself. Anyways, comment some more DIY ideas for DIY Wolfie to smash next time. Usually I'm successful. Today I wasn't the most successful, but usually I'm successful.
No, you're not.
Yeah,
that's
why. And I will see you guys soon with another banger video. And as always, stay savage. Lego. Thought I was good. Ah.
All right, you're done.
One out at a time. They said I couldn't do it. All right. Guys, look at these shot glasses. They're actually